Hello student, welcome back, and today we are going to continue our series part 2 for 2018, and previously we finished until this question. Yeah, so we are going to continue with question number 4, which shows what is this, food chain or food web? Obviously this is a food web, okay? I almost highlight this thing, okay? It's a food web because it's like a web, okay? Many things in it is a combination of food chain. Write the food chain containing it which has the greatest number of trophic level. So the student didn't get any mark. So let's look at the food chain. It will start from a seaweed. After seaweed, it will be go to shellfish. Then it will go to crab. After crab, will go to octopus. Octopus will go to sea lion. And sea lion will go to killer whale. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So seaweed, shellfish, crab. After crab is supposed to be octopus, sea lion, and killer whale. So the student didn't get this correct, I'm thinking. Yeah, didn't correct, Not. Well, I don't know want to give one mark or not, but because here say has the greatest number, so this one is not the answer, so no mark for this question. Suggest why the food chain you have written A1 is unusual. Seaweed and shellfish are producer. No, shellfish is not the producer. Producer usually can undergo photosynthesis, right? So what are the problem with this food chain? It consists more than 4 trophic level. Okay, consists more of 4 trophic level. So of course usually there's only 4 level, right? Producer, primary consumer, secondary consumer, third-tier consumer. So usually it's 4, but this one is more than 4. Chemical energy is low at each level. One reason is food chain. Yes, correct or not? As it go up the trophic level, the energy is getting lesser. And one of the reason is respiration, because the energy is used for respiration. List 2 uses of the energy released by respiration of all, right? 2 uses. So maybe you can say for growth, or you can say for protein synthesis. Okay, so I didn't give any mark for this one. But of course, actually for movement also, I want to give correct, because respiration can produce movement. But I just follow the marking scheme, for growth and protein synthesis. Describe 2 ways in which the energy is wasted when the killer whale eat the sea lion. Okay, for excretion, and some part of it is not eaten. So, 1, so there will be some loss of energy because the killer whale didn't eat the thing, and the killer whale also don't really digest the sea lion 100%. So some of the energy will be excreted out, the chemical energy will be excreted out. Question number 5, calcium sulfate is an insoluble salt, okay? Name 2 compounds that can react together to form calcium sulfate. So you use calcium carbonate and sulfuric acid. Very good. So get 2 mark. Suggest separation method to separate insoluble salt. Okay, you use filtration. After you mix it, you got it. And what you want to do is explanation, because the thing cannot pass through. Okay, you filter it, then you might want to wipe it and dry it, and then you can get the salt. Calcium is a good electric conductor, correct or not? Because calcium is a calcium is in group 2, so it's a metal. Calcium is a good electric conductor. Calcium has a high melting point. Okay, no problem. 1 mark. 2 must be correct. State the electronic configuration of calcium. So you need to look at the periodic table and find calcium. So periodic table for calcium, the proton number is in your exam paper, I can So if you go to your periodic table and the last pages, you can find that your proton number for calcium will be 20. So you drew the electric configuration be 2.8.8.2, 2+8+8+2, you get back 20, okay? Calcium is below potassium in group 1. Potassium melt at 63 and react rapidly. Calcium is solid at room temperature, 25 Celsius. Compare the rate of reaction between calcium and water. Of course, reactor of calcium with water. Reaction with calcium and water is more, correct? Now, as it go down the periodic table, it is more reactive because it is more reactive than potassium. As it go down, it will be more reactive. Suggest the melting point of calcium. So it will be around 40, between 63 and 25. You don't write 62 lah, huh? Somewhere between around 40 should be okay. 40 lah, huh? Somewhere between. D, describe the reaction in which occur when copper is mixed with aqueous potassium chloride. So what happened? No reaction, correct or not? Because if you study the series of reactivity of metal, we know that potassium is at top and copper is at the bottom. So potassium cannot replace copper because copper is less reactive, or you can say potassium is more reactive than copper. It is the same, up to you. Next question, number 6, show a liquid and glass in a thermometer. State the property of the liquid used in the thermometer. It has a thermal expansion. Okay, because it say state the property of the liquid. The question didn't ask state the things, state the type of the liquid or the element of the liquid. Okay, so the property of the liquid is, it is very sensitive towards, why this thing always come up? Didn't click also it come up. Okay, thermal expansion. Okay, it's very good at thermal, or sensitive at thermal expansion. Table 6.1 gives a melting point and boiling point of 5 substance. So there will be ethanol, gallium, glycerol, mercury and water. Ammonia has a melting point of negative 78 and a boiling point of negative 33. Explain why ethanol would be the best suitable to measure in the liquid in glass thermometer to measure both the melting point and boiling point of ammonia. So we look at ammonia. Ammonia is negative 78 and negative 33. So which you want to use ethanol? Why ethanol is the best? Because it is liquid in those both temperature, correct or not? It is liquid. We don't want to, like, for example, we don't want to take like water, because it just doesn't work. Because if we take water, then how to measure the is negative ammonia. Even before you measure, the water already freeze inside the thermometer. So there's nothing to measure because the water is freeze. But if you look at ethanol, it's negative. The range is negative 114 and 78. So it is still liquid. You want to make it to become solid, you need to measure it, the degree Celsius, negative 114. So it's still liquid, so you can put in the thermometer. Gallium cannot. Gallium will become solid, water will become solid. Glycerol and mercury also cannot, because it will become solid, negative 78. So there's nothing to measure. See, an infrared thermometer, like the one that put on your forehead, tip infrared thermometer, measure the temperature differently. The wavelength of the infrared is emitted by the body. Of course, infrared thermometer is not that good lah. It's not that good because it's not that accurate, because it's based on your surface of your forehead or you here. No lah, usually people put at forehead lah. So sometimes when you run here, it's a bit lah, or you the sun, due to sunrise or what, then it just measure the surface. So you need to wait for a while and measure. the better thermometer will be the clinical thermometer that you put inside your mouth, because inside your mouth is the inner side of your body, so it will measure more accurate. That's why doctors still use that one. Doctor don't use it that one. Can lah, but not that accurate lah. Who knows the aircon you sit, the swan sit at the aircon there. Or for baby, they put the ear or the rectum. So you want to get the thermometer inside the body to get the measurement as accurate as possible. The wavelength of the infrared radiation emitted decrease the temperature of the hot body. Predict what happened to the frequency of infrared radiation as the temperature body arise. So the frequency will increase. You need to say V, anything related to V equal F lambda. Means you say that, let's see the question. Let me read the question. Infrared thermometer measure the wavelength that emitted to convert radiation. The wavelength of the infrared decrease. So the wavelength it decrease in terms of mathematics. The wavelength decrease, so this one go down. What will happen to the frequency? Will go up, because V will be constant, correct or not? Infrared, what is the speed of infrared? What is the speed of infrared?
Of light.
Yeah, speed of light, which is
3 × 10⁸
unit.
Meter per second.
Very good. So we know that infrared and light is actually has the constant speed of which the speed of light. So therefore it is constant. So if you say that the wavelength decrease, the frequency increase. But you don't do like that lah. I just draw like this so that you understand. You just write your own word. Okay. You say that prediction. It will increase the frequency. Because V, you just write this formula, V equals to F lambda, and then you just put a comma. As the wavelength decrease, the frequency will increase. You can say lah, the V is constant if you want. Just explain the formula like how you explain to your friend, okay? But don't just write like this and leave it like that, then you will get wrong. You need to at least explain a bit. At least you need to explain that, when the wavelength in reference to V equal F lambda, when wavelength decrease, frequency increase, something like that. Just explain it a bit. In the infrared thermometer, you will get 1 mark. I forget to write this one. You'll get 1 mark. In infrared thermometer, the radiation is focused into the detector by thin converging lens. You draw it correctly, Okay, you want to draw arrow here also, okay? It's better to draw arrow, but if you don't draw also, it is still correct, okay? 1 point for this question. Number 7, a student investigating a photosynthesis in an aquatic plant, blah, blah, don't know, ask how many billion times already this question. Show the apparatus to collect oxygen. It's always my dream experiment from a kid, I want to collect oxygen. And explain why the water in the test tube moves downward, because oxygen gas is given off, correct or not? Maybe after you wait for 1 week, then you will collect a lot of oxygen. And how you want to test the gas of oxygen?
Lighted wooden splinter.
Yeah, correct. Okay, put the lighted wooden splinter near the mouth of the test tube. It is called glowing wooden splinter near the mouth of the test tube. The fire will rekindle in case the question asks lah, but here we know it didn't, but it's good to know. Who knows when the question want to ask. The investigation is repeated in a condition with greater light intensity. Of course, if you put more light, there is more photosynthesis. Lesser light, there's lesser photosynthesis. Draw a line to suggest.
Drew that line.
Okay. I thought this is a question paper. Yep, so it's correct. As long as the line is below a bit, then you get this correct. I thought the student didn't do anything. So the student will get 1 mark for this question. Okay, next. Explain your answer. The greater the light intensity, the faster the rate of photosynthesis, so more oxygen is given off. How do we want to explain this question? Actually, this is correct. More, I didn't read properly. Oxygen gas given off. Okay, correct. This one is correct. Maybe you want to say oxygen gas given off and to displace the water, but it's still correct lah, huh? When the oxygen given off, you get 1 point. Explain why acid rain reduce the rate of photosynthesis. It will destroy the leaf, but I still give correct lah. The structure of the chloroplast is the leaf, so I just give correct. So 1 point, 1 mark for this question. Describe 2 measurements that can be used to reduce acid rain. Of course, it's correct. Reducing fossil fuel recycling, but the marking scheme put these 2 together. So when they put these 2 together, it might be like these 2 is only 1 mark. But I will still give correct lah, because I cannot say recycling is the same as fossil fuel. But the better answer, I believe, will be putting a or installing a catalytic converter. Okay, catalytic converter is for the factory. When the factory, before the factory release the gas, they installs the catalytic converter on the or the electrostatic precipitator. At the what is it called, the chimney, near the chimney, like the factory thing lah, the thing, and it will convert the gas to make it more environmental friendly. So it's more, that's why I say this answer is more catalytic converter. Installing catalytic converter is more accurate when we are talking about reducing acid rain, because we cannot ask the factory to close down, correct or not? We need to do something. At least people still got job, and we don't want to pollute the environment. Of course, all these things produce money, need money, and I don't think it's cheap. So some factory that maybe they want to save money, then but it's not worth it lah. After you save money, when the government find out and the newspaper come, and it's not really worth the risk of maybe even you save 1 million, but you go out to see the newspaper, it's really not worth it. But maybe some survive lah, some survive until death, I don't know lah, but it's not a not worth it risk. Number 8, useful substance are obtained by petroleum using the process shown in figure 8.1. So this is a fractional distillation column, you know lah, I hope you know . Compare the sizes of the molecule. Of course, the size of the molecule is larger in cube, but it's better to explain a bit . Larger in cube as compared with P. Better lah, because when you say larger in Q, fraction Q, can also lah, that's why I still give correct, but it's better that you give the statement more accurate. Okay, intermolecular is stronger in fraction Q as compared with P, or fraction Q is stronger than fraction P. Then it is, you answer this like this, it is better. Because the sentence show a more comprehensive answer. Because stronger in fraction Q means what is it? Down here still some more got leh. Even the marking scheme also say that what compared to what? What compared to what? But I still give correct lah. Fraction P contains propane C3H6H8. Construct the balance equation, very good. Just write out plus oxygen, if you get carbon dioxide plus water, then you balance the equation, you get 2 mark, very good. Process Y produce alkene molecule and large alkane molecule. State the molecular structure of alkane different from alkene. Alkene contain single bond. So wrong, alkane contain double bond. Alkene contain double bond. Alkane contain single bond. So it's a very direct question, so the student didn't get any mark. How to test propene and propane? One of the way to test is we want to use bromine water test. So if propene, the water will decolorize. Very good. It put transparent, but most books say decolorize lah, so I just put. If not, it will remain the same. Very good. Bromine water will remain the same. Okay, figure 9.1 show a dishwasher. So this is a dishwasher that is not common in Malaysia. Of course, it's very common in Western country, which I something that maybe due to culture different or what. You know, Asian won't use this thing. Asian will use their hand to wash hand. If you use this machine, your parents will probably scold you, lazy. Lazy people that don't want to wash dishes. But I don't know why American they wash this. I also want to buy this. I thought want to save money. And not save money, save time. I'm gonna just put that and the dishwasher uses electrical energy power heater. Yeah, this question we need read properly. So I read slowly a bit. The dishwasher uses electric energy power heater to heat the water. Okay, you want to heat the water. This one is basically by high pressure. The water will you don't use the robot hand to wash. They just use like the water laser water, like high pressure water, just spray it to clean it. So you need a high motor power to clean the dishes and the pump. Yeah, you want to pump the water. The motor that produce the pump, that make the pump. And the lamp to indicate that the heater is switched on. So when you there's light, when there's no motor, then we know that the motor is spoiled because there is current. If there's no light, then maybe we want to check the current first before we do anything. Yeah, maybe it's not the motor spoiled, there's no current into it. So if no light, usually I will take test pen to test to make sure there is current in from the socket or use other thing first. But if there is light and no sound from the motor, probably some short circuit or the motor is spoiled. The circuit symbol for heater and motor are heater and motor. So you wash your hot water to wash the plate, correct or not? Like sanitize the plate so that it's more clean. Figure 9.1 show part of the circuit diagram. So this one is 240 volt alternating current, which is the same as Malaysia socket. And UK, Malaysia and UK socket is the same, 240. Of course, when you go to China, I think the voltage is slightly lesser a bit, and they are using alternating current. Let's read the question. Just now I'm thinking like how to draw. But you cannot draw, you know, because we haven't read finish the question. This is very important. Then I'm looking that I don't know what the question is talking about. Oh, then suddenly I see all this thing. Each of the motor and heater has a switch. So this is the keyword lah. Each motor and heater has a switch. So there will be three switch. Well, each motor one switch. And the heater also you one switch. So at least there is three switch at here. The heater and each motor are turned at different time. Means that I can turn the heater or the motor, each motor, you know, not motors, but each motor at different time. So of course, name the type of the circuit parallel, draw the diagram. So the student only get 1 mark because the light bulb is correct. Just let me erase this thing. Can I erase this thing? Okay, so this is correct already, okay? After the current, we want to reduce the current. We don't want to use 240 volt to go to the but it's given in the question. Then we want to put a switch here to make sure that it can on off. According to this question, each motor 3 circuit has a switch in series. Okay, so let's put it in series. That's why we put here. Here is the series to make sure that one switch control everything. But here also say that the heater and each motor are turned at different times. So you need 2 switch in order to make this. Because you say first it is at series, each motor and 3 heater switch is in series, not in parallel. And after that, the heater, each motor are turned on at different time. So after you draw the first switch, you need to draw the second switch. and the third switch. Okay, then one to the heater, then to the light bulb, this one to the motor, this one to the motor. Okay, so this will be your diagram. At least it will be something like that. I think this question is a bit tough lah, because the keyword is at here, saying that each of the motor and heater has a switch in series. So they are talking about this switch in series. After that, they say the heater and each motor are turned on at different time. So you can turn on it at different time by putting another three switch at here. So it's a difficult question. Yeah, it's a difficult question. Okay, the heater is rated at 2.4 kilowatt. Just remember that. I think the student always do mistake. I think a few. I will say that 20% student in the class will do this mistake. It's supposed to be 2,400 watt, not 2.4 kilowatt. Then when you put in your formula, you will get it wrong. The power quotient and the inductance can be ignored. State the formula. Formula, you get 1 mark. Current, power, in voltage. But the student didn't finish it. Why didn't finish it?
Where is the voltage?
Good question. Where is the voltage? So the power is 2,400. Current equals to power divided by voltage. Where is the voltage? Of course, they give you the voltage ready, 240. So what is the answer?
Oh, I didn't see. Wait.
Yeah, so wasted. So what is your answer?
10.
240. The answer current will be 10 ampere. Yeah, just be careful, make sure there is a unit. But the student just get 1 mark because the student got write the formula. But if you cannot do this one, you also cannot do the bottom. Then the bottom one also will get wrong. Because when you cannot get this one, you cannot get this one. Each motor running at a take 1.2 ampere. Find the maximum of 240 watt heater and both motor. So if both motor, one motor is 1.2, two motor is 2.4. So it's correct already, 2.4. But we didn't calculate the heater. What is the current for the heater, which we already do in question 1. The current for the heater is 10. The heater blah blah blah. Calculate the current in the heater, which we get 10. So we need to get 2.4 plus 10. So you get 12.4. So this answer 12.4, you didn't get correct. Damn, wrong. Suggest a suitable value for the circuit. So because it is already 12.4, you need to use 13 ampere. Wow, this question is quite tough. I don't know how student will know. 13 ampere fuse or 20. The reason I know, because I like to fix my house thing, so I will open the socket, and when you want to buy the fuse, is you write there, you if you see properly lah, you open your socket, you open it, and it will write there one 30A. 13A means 13 ampere. You won't get 14 ampere, 13.5 ampere, 13.1 ampere, you just cannot get there. When you go to DIY, when you go to shop to buy, they only give you 13 or 20 only. Or even 30 ampere for your outside your house one, 50 ampere also got. And if an electrician will know this lah, because they commonly go to the shop. But I don't know how student want to get this unless it's written in the textbook lah. But it must be 13. Oh yeah, any value lah, 13, 14, 15. Reason, it supplies a higher current that is safe to use and avoid making avoid putting the machine at risk. Actually, this one is correct. Higher current to save to use and avoid melting the circuit lah. I think the better word is avoid short circuit lah, huh? Avoid short circuit or maybe we can avoid putting the component at risk. Putting the component at risk. So I give wrong lah, huh? Because the better word is putting the component at risk, because there's a short circuit and too much current going through, so the circuit will break. But you hear when you say melt, I'm thinking like the wire start to melt. Of course, it's still possible the wire can melt too hot. It's common the wire melt and fire outbreak happen. But never mind lah, I just if wrong. So yep, thank you very much. So